The final question over there, please.
Thank you. My name is Yusmadi Yusof. I'm from Malaysia, Member of Parliament. On confluence of civilizations, I'm for what Excellency say about collaborative entrepreneurship, so to speak. But being a young leaders here, I would like to ask your suggestion, because for me, I'm struggling to really understand Mahabharata, and even to understand Sangoyangyi. And I have to say, with full of humility, I will never touch China if I cannot understand Sangoyangyi or the Three Kingdoms. I will never touch India if I cannot understand Mahabharata. But at the same time, you mentioned unity in diversity, which I know, as a matter of fact, is a very, I would say, effective principles. All this while practiced in Indonesia. With all this strength in this region, can you suggest, I mean, taking the points of to have a righteous of heart, leadership of magnanimity, can you suggest something for someone like me or many more young leaders in this region? Thank you very much.
Yeah, I have met so far 12 million young people below 25 years, last 10 years, 12 million people. One of the questions they ask me is how I can be a unique person. How I can be unique person. Now, when I study religion, I have studied all religions. There are two components of every religion. One is theology, another is spirituality. Now, theology is very special for every religion. You can't touch it. If you touch it, you have had it. So, but spirituality, if you go deep into every religious sacred document, you find is common. Almost all the religions say that always you think in terms of what can I give. That is the spirituality. So I am advocating, why not we connect the spirituality component of the religion and get a bridge to really religion, that society, and then civilization. That's my push. You can ask me, is it possible at all? Is it possible to connect the religions? I give you an example. Somewhere southern part of India, there's a place called Tumba. Tumba, there was my guru, my teacher was Vikram Sarabhai. He wanted to establish a space research center there because the equatorial region, the equator is passing through nearest area. So he wanted about 400 acres of the land. That land, government said we won't give because there's a church, Catholic church is there. There's a bishop house there, and there are thousands of fishing community studying there. We can't give. Now my guru, he is a very man of steadfastness. He said, you give me solution, how do I get that land? They gave other type of land. Then he said, only one person can help you. That is Reverend Father Peter Parira. Reverend Father Peter Parira, Prasada Sakti, Vikram Sarabhai, my professor, met him. Told him we need land for scientific research. And Reverend Father said, the Bishop said, oh, you, Vikram, you are asking me my home, Bishop House. You are asking me my God's home. And you ask me my people's home, thousands. How can I give? But both of them, both Professor Vikram Sarabhai and Reverend Father Peter Parira, they had commonality between them. They can smile at difficult time. They smiled. Next day, he was invited to the church, and he went to the church. Vikram Sarabhai went to the church, and Bishop Reverend Father Peter Parira introduced Vikram. Here is a scientist. What science do? Science helps people materially. It gives a telephone, it gives the mic, it gives the healthcare, it gives some prosperity, and agriculture productivity increases. And what preacher like me does, that is a bishop, what he does, he gives peace to the people. Peace to the people. So science and spirituality, religion, have to meet together. Can he use the land of 400 acres for scientific purpose? There was a pin drop silence. Then all of them, thousands of people, they got up, they said, Amen. The church was given, the bishop also was given, the whole place was given for scientific work. But here we see the two great minds of two religious minds, your spiritual and scientific mind, they work together. It is possible to connect the societies. And this is the type of message we should collect nationally, internationally, spread the message, connect the civilization and societies.
Thank you, President Kalam. President Kalam demonstrated today that he straddles the pillars of scientists and technologists, as well as that of a humanist. He has given us a thought-provoking address, and could I ask you to join me in thanking President Kalam?
Thank you, Your Excellency, Dr. Kalam and Ambassador Barry Dasker.